exactly, yeah.
Wildfires and their response, the governor acknowledged, always attract close scrutiny.
In each fire, you learn something that you can do better than the next time to prevent those fires from happening.
In the case of the Auburn fire, even before the embers cool, CAL FIRE is facing hard questions in the face of complaints from some residents about the dispatch of local crews.
I have not heard that yet. However, in a situation like this, as dynamic and devastating as it is, things cannot happen fast enough, and I can completely understand why people may feel that way.
Were resources dispatched in a timely fashion?
Absolutely. Our incident commander, within the first 20 minutes, had already requested 50 additional engines. That's an extremely large number for the first initial attack of a wildfire.
Berlant defends their dispatching decision, saying the destruction could have been far worse if not for that response. County leaders agree.
Had you heard any complaints, though, about certain resources not being dispatched quickly?
Just secondhand information, but nothing real serious that I've heard of.
Any questions in your mind about whether this could be done better or lessons learned?
You know, we have a great response team in Placer County, and we have drills all the time for this kind of thing. And I don't think we could have done it any better.
But the county's Office of Emergency Services is acknowledging complaints about a lack of updates on its website during Sunday's firefight.
Is the website not considered to be a crucial piece of information as far as dissemination of public information?
No, I think increasingly it's an important one. I guess I would argue, though, in the early stages of a fire or other emergency, you can't do everything.
Back here live in the fire zone, Fitch did tell us that initially they put a top priority on answering phone calls, and he says in retrospect they probably should have devoted more time to updating information on their county website for people to get updated. So look for that to be one lesson that is obviously going to come out of this Auburn fire. One other thing to tell you about, we are understanding from new information from CAL FIRE that the fire is now considered to be 70% contained at this point. And Gulston, we're also told that as of 7 p.m. tonight, residents will be allowed back here into the burn zone. That is going to be good news for people who are very anxious to get in here and survey the damage if they don't know the exact extent of that damage. In fact, we just saw several people here who were arrested by the Placer County Sheriff's Department because they moved into this neighborhood to check things out after being warned to stay away. Gulston, back to you.
That's right, and they didn't heed that warning, and we saw what happened. They were arrested. Kevin, quickly, firefighters always train and train and train for all kinds of eventualities, and you have to wonder how that played into what happened yesterday.
Yeah, that's right. You know, any firefighting professional is going to tell you that this is an imperfect situation and that no fire is ever going to go perfectly. So what they do is they review these fires as a matter of course, if for no other reason but to learn from them, as sort of a post-mortem, and to learn in a training aspect. So you can expect that they'll be reviewing this fire in that same fashion.
All right, Kevin Ricks, thanks for that part of our coverage.